this is, we are having this international code for safe carriage of grain. So this is grain code, and what all are important here is we will go through these things. Okay, so it is a required application of this code is, this code applies to the ships regardless of size, means no sizes, including those less than 500 tons also, or gross tons, engaged in carriage of the grain in bulk, to which the Part C of the Chapter 6 of the SOLAS Convention as amended applies. So grain for all ships regardless of the size, including vessels which are less than 500 GTs, and it is included in Part C of the Chapter 6 of the SOLAS. Now there are few definitions which are, so definition we have, what is grain? So it covers wheat, maize, oat, rye, barley, rice, pulses, seeds, and processed form of thereof, whose behavior is similar to that of the grain in the natural state. That's why the granular sulfur also comes over here. So what is the meaning, how this wheat, maize, you can just remember that when you eat wheat, when you eat maize, so by remembering this, like generally wheat, we are having the chapatis and all this, so we can have in the morning or we can have in the evening. Then maize, oats, when you eat rye, barley, rices, pulses and seeds, so whatever times, so I was remembering all these, or it can be like a rhythm also, like wheat, maize, oats, rye, barley, rice, pulse and seeds. So you can make any rhythm and then you can remember. Then the term filled compartment refers to any cargo spaces in which the after loading the loading and trimming as required under regulation 10.2. so sometimes it is like, why trimming is required? So it is required as per this 10.2, that's why. And to show you, this is Part A of the annex. So this is Part A, so anything will be A1, A2. This definition is like A2, so this is something just to make you understand that what is A10. So where will be 10 written, that is A10. Then the term filled compartment and untrimmed refers to a cargo space which is filled to the maximum extent possible in the way to the hatch openings, but which has not been trimmed outside the periphery of the hatch cover opening by the provision of A10.3.1 for all the ships, or 10.3.2 for the specially suitable compartment. So this is like for the special ships and for the specially suitable compartments. Then we will see what, then partly filled compartment, this definitions. The more important is this one, specially suitable compartment refers to a cargo spaces which is constructed with at least two vertical or sloping longitudinal grain tight divisions which are coincidental with the hatch side girders, or are so positioned to the limit and the effect of any transverse shifting of the grain if sloping the division have an inclination of not less than 30 to the horizontal. So what is specially suitable compartments? Here it is written like at least two vertical sloping longitudinally grain tight division. This means that grain tight division, there is a compartment, let's say this whole thing is a compartment, and at least two vertical or sloping. So sloping is something like this is sloping over here, this is also sloping. So let's say that this is the whole compartment and this is something like sloping. So this should all, this is there, and okay, longitudinal I will tell, then grain tight divisions which are coincident with the hatch side girders, okay, and are positioned to limit the grain tight division which are coincident with the hatch side girders. So here will be hatch side girder, let's say the there is something like hatch side girder with which this is hatch side girder, and here also we have like such hatch side girder. and from here only we are having like this, and from here also we are having like this. So this will be like slopings. R saw position limit the effect of any transverse shifting of the if the sloping division. So what is if the sloping division, okay, have an inclination of not less than 30 to the horizontal. So this is horizontal, this here is, this is horizontal. So this thing and here this thing shall not be more than 30, shall not be, actually it is written that, or this one we can say that this thing here, that not less than the division of the inclination with shall not be less than 30 degree. So this thing shall not be less than 30 degree to the horizontal. So this thing shall not be less than, so this thing also shall not be less than 30 degree to the horizontal. This thing, I mean this thing shall not be less than 30 degree to the horizontal. Okay, and then it is saying that longitudinal. So longitudinal, this, let's say that this is full hatch cover. So longitudinal division will be something like this. This is longitudinal division, this is longitudinal division, and for this one there will be hole over here to put the cargo. Then here it will be here, and here it will be here. So like this we can just put our cargoes in the holds like this, and the longitudinal divisions are being given. So this is how it is. Okay, now for the grain loading, the most important is document of authorization. So a document of authorization shall be issued for the ship loaded in accordance with the regulation of this code. Okay, and now the document shall accompany or incorporated into the grain loading manual. So inside the grain loading manual, DOA should be there. Such a document, grain loading stability data and the associated plans may be drawn up in the official language. It should be drawn in different languages. Then a copy of such document, grain loading stability data and associated plans, shall be placed on board in order that the master, if so required, shall produce for the inspection of the contracting government of the country of the port of loading. So a copy also shall be provided so that master can so in case any contracting government or in case of inspection or any port says that okay, we want to know that how it is to be done or something, master can demonstrate that, master can tell them or give it to them. So a ship without such documents, without such a, it means that copy of DOA, this copy of DOA shall be incorporated. It is not that okay, copy of copy somebody wants, so okay, you want it, you can take it. A ship without, but there is no need to say all these. This is that a copy is there, that's it, finish, nothing more. So a ship without such a document of authorization shall not load grain. So it was like key, who's having document of authorization, it should be grain loading manual should be there, which is to be incorporated with DOA, and grain loading stability data should be there, and a copy of such document shall, and the grain stability data and all this should be there so that master can demonstrate to the other parties. And now in case they want here a ship without DOA. Now without DOA means the master has to do it. There is no like in case they want or something, he has to do it. So shall not carry grain until the master demonstrate to the satisfaction of the administration that this is okay, and means my vessel will be safe enough to carry the grain. Equivalence, exemptions, not of so important. Then stability requirements. Okay, this is important. So the intact stability characteristic of a ship carrying bulk grain. This is the ships which is having DOA and it is carrying the cargo. So the angle of heel due to shift of the grain shall not angle of heel, you can say. So the angle of heel shall not be greater than 12 degrees or in the case of ship constructed on or after 1st January 1994, the angle at which the deck edge commences. So ship constructed on or after 1st January 1994, so if the vessel is constructed after 1st January 1994, the angle at which the deck emerges, whichever is less. So the word is whichever is less. So 12 degree or at an angle which at which it deck, that is the top deck or the flooding can start. So that deck, when it is immersed into the water, whichever is less, that can be 10 degree also, that can be 8 degree also, maybe the ship is constructed such that. So this is given whichever is less. So if it will be 8, so it will be 8, it will not be 12. So if it is 23 or 50, let's say, so it will be 50, it will be 12, not 50 or 23. Okay, now static stability diagram. So we have to say, we have to read this one also, that in the static stability diagram, we've on the stability requirements. So stability requirement, the angle of heel for the ships which are carrying the bulk grains. So the angle of heel shall not be greater than 12 degrees or in case of the ship constructed on and after 1st January 1994. So if the ship is constructed before 19 on and after 94 afterwards or on, so the angle at which the deck edge immerses. So deck edge immersion or 12 degree, whichever is less, is the criteria for the ship. And now in the static stability diagram, the net or the residual area between the heeling arm curve. So what is that? This is heeling arm curve and the riding arm curve to the angle of heel of maximum. So the heel of maximum difference between the ordinates of the two curves or 40 degree. So this is in static stability diagram. The residual area, residual area between heeling arm curve and the riding arm curve up to heel of maximum difference between the ordinates or to 40 degree. Shall in all condition of loading be not less than 0.075 meter radians. So in simple languages, if to say we have static stability diagram, residual area between heeling arm curve and the riding arm curve. So I'll just show you here the diagram. This is your riding arm, this is our heeling arm curve, this is heeling arm curve, this is riding arm curve. So I will draw like this only. So what does this point number 2 says? So this is our diagram somewhat. So healing arm curve is something like, just a second, just to show you one. Okay. It's from here. It's something like this. Okay. So now this is a writing arm, this is healing arm curve. So this one is showing healing arm curve over here, this is showing writing arm curve. So just to show writing arm, healing arm. Okay, now what it is saying, the static stability diagram, the net residual area between healing arm curve and the writing arm curve. So net residual area will be this thing, this what is shaded. Between his writing arm and healing arm, this portion. Because this curve will go more down also like this, and this will also go like this. So what is remaining is this area here, this area. So they saying residual area between the healing arm curve and the writing arm curve up to the angle of maximum difference between the ordinates, or to the 40 degree. So this is maximum difference is still here, this thing is still here, or 40 degree or the angle of flooding. So it is 40 degrees, let's say 40 degrees coming somewhat here, here 40 degrees coming. 40 degrees coming till here. So this one, or to angle of flooding. So angle of flooding can be 40 degree or can be less also, 37, like here can be, it can be less also. So here also you can see that this is the residual area here, you can see. So this is writing arm, this is healing arm. So this is the residual area between, and this angle is 40 degree here, 40 degree a, and the angle of flooding. So here it is saying that angle of flooding, that is heel of the maximum difference between the ordinates, so maximum difference between the ordinates or 40 degree or the angle of flooding. So it is on the three bases, that is 40 degrees or angle of flooding or maximum separation between these two arms. So it is heel of maximum difference between the ordinates of two curve. So maximum ordinates will difference will be, maximum is this thing, can be maximum, this can be maximum, no, the ordinate over here and the ordinate over here will be two different things. So here and the here are different, no, so it is on the same thing. So it is value is less than this over here somewhat, and here the value of this one is about here. So this is the difference. So this means the point number first one is the heel of maximum difference between the ordinate is this one, is this one, this and this. Then the, it is saying 40 degrees. So 40 degree is this one, or maximum angle of flooding it can be 37, can be 47, or if 37 then it should be over here, means before, or if it is 47 it will be afterwards. But whichever is less, the last lines are whichever is least, whichever is least shall in all condition of loading be not less than 0.075 meter radians. So this is what it means. And then the initial metacentric height, initial metacentric height shall not be less than 0.3 meters. this one is okay. So after loading, so here are few things about the GZ curve. I want to tell you this, that okay, this is angle of heel due to a shifting. This is angle of heel. Here is writing arm. Here is angle of heel. So writing arm and angle of heel. This is G. You can say GZ also. Then this is writing arm curve. This one is healing arm curve. This tangentially is going at a degree of 57. Here can be something like, here can be like GM. Then if this curve will be more extended, it will come down and it will cut this line, cut our angle of heel something here. So this is angle of vanishing stability here. Then whatever will be negative over here, let's say this curve is going more like this, and then it will come over like this, or it goes more down. So this area below the line is negative area. Okay, then this is okay. Now here is value of GM at different angle of heels. You see, here is angle of heel, and here will be the value of writing arm curve, that is GZ. So GZ value at different angle of heels you can determine. Then we have maximum GZ value, GZ max of over here. So max GZ maximum value at the angle of heel. Then GM we can determine. Then angle of heel we have. Then writing arm curve. So all this. Now here is some formula how to calculate lambda 0 and lambda 40. So lambda 0 is assumed volumetric healing due to transfer shift and stowage factor into displacement, and lambda 40 is decimal 8 into lambda 0. So it is like 80% of lambda 0. So all this, and then A9, operational stability requirement for the ships without DOA carrying partly cargoes of the bulk grain. So what is that? The total weight of the bulk grain shall not exceed 1/3 of the dead weight of the ship. It shall not increase. Now, is this all filled compartments trimmed shall be fitted with center line divisions extended for the full length of the such compartment. From where? From the underside of the deck or hatch cover to the distance below the deck line. So it is the center line division this is for filled compartment trimmed. So the center line division extending how much? Full length of such compartment down from the underside of the deck or the hatch cover to the distance below the center line of at least 1/8 of the maximum breadth of the compartment or 2.4 meter, whichever is greater. Okay. So it is saying if it is a filled compartment and it is trimmed, filled compartment and trimmed, then if the vessel is without DOA, then center line division should be there, which should be throughout the length of the compartment. So it is throughout the length of the compartment and downwards from the underside of the deck or the hatch cover to a distance below the deck line of at least 1/8 of the maximum breadth of the compartment or 2.4 meter, whichever is greater. So let us assume that this is our hold. So here is something like, till here is the hatch covers and all this. something like, so it should go down from here to, let's say, here. Till here, this is our, this full is our central line division. So this central line division is this one, at least 1/8 of the maximum breadth of the compartment, or 2.4 meter, whichever is greater. So this one is this thing. Okay, now 2.4 meter, whichever is greater. This one is finished. Now in accordance, except that saucer constructed in accordance with A.14. So either the central line division or saucering can be done also in accordance with A14, may be accepted in lieu of the central line division. It is written that in lieu of the central line division it can be accepted, and beneath a hatch cover except in case of the linseeds. So except in case of the linseeds and other seeds having similar properties. So in case of linseed and the other seeds having similar properties, so what is that? That it is having a marshy effect, and it keeps the person same, like we have marsh islands. So if somebody goes in the marsh, so he will go keep on going down only. So it will be linseeds having the same behavior. So next is all hatch cover of the filled compartments antrum shall be closed. Okay, and all free grain surface of partly filled cargo spaces shall be trimmed, leveled and secured in accordance with A16, A17 and A18. So what I mean to say is that saucering, bundling, or we have wire mesh lashing, or we have strappings, these all are for the vessels which are without DOA. This is not for the vessels which is with DOA. With DOA, that ship is itself is certified, so no lashing, nothing, as well as they are having specially suitable compartments, so there is no need. So actually that ships are already constructed to carry grain, that's why they don't need these lashings. Okay, now the lashing, volumetric healing moment and all this is different, but for the, because this is all written for the ships without DOA, that's why. And what it should be like, A14, A16, 17, 18, whatever is being complied with. Now, throughout the voyage, metacentric height after the correction of free surface effect of the liquid in the tank shall be 0.3, or that given by the formula, whichever is greater. So it should be greater, not less than 0.3 meters. And the formula is this one. The values are given, what is L, what is B, what is SF, BM, and okay, you can have a look of this formula. And after all this, the master shall demonstrate to the satisfaction of the administration also. Okay, next is 10, stowage of bulk grains. So all the necessary and reasonable trimming shall be performed to the level of all free grain surface and to minimize the effect of grain shifting. So trimming is, there are different reasons for trimming. So there are many things, like it will accommodate more space and more cargo can be placed inside, and there will be less shifting of the grains and all this. This is stowing of the, why the trimming is required. So this is not so difficult one, everyone can answer this one. So okay, here is also A16, whatever was written over here. Now actually I want to show this one. A14, what is A14, 16, 17 and 18. So just to remember that partly filled is 16, 17, 18. you can just go through once that how it is done and what is there. So it will be more easy. Now this is 14. So there it was written A14 also, but for the filled compartment. So this is actually, this is in section A. So A14, saucering. Okay, now saucering, what is to be done? It is for the filled and trunk compartments for the ships with a molded depth of up to, we have to remember like this only, that up to 0.9.91 meters, not less than 1.2 meters. So molded it up to, so we have to remember up to, for the ship with a molded breadth of 1.18.3 meters or more. So 18.3 meters or more, not less than 1.8 meters. This is the depth of the saucer actually. The depth of the saucer is up to 9.1 meter, 1.2, and if breadth is 18.3 or more than 1.8, and for the ship's molded breadth between 9.1 to 18.3 meter, the interpolation, nothing else. So for the saucering, just to show you this one here, this is, here is the saucering. So saucering here, the bags are placed, then the tarpaulin is placed like this, bags are played with a grain. So with this 19 mm of the wire rope is used, 32 mm of the turnbuckle, minimum 4 dogs and the grip should be there, and distance between the lashing shall not increase 2.4 meters. So this is the criteria. How it is to be done? Firstly, what we should do? Firstly, the wire rope. Wire ropes shall be placed at 2.4 meter intervals. Then above that, the tarpaulins should be placed, and then inside the tarpaulin bag should be placed, and then cover up the tarpaulin, then tight the rope using the, so this is cover up the tarpaulin and then stitch it also. You can stitch this one tarpaulin so that it will not go off, and then tight the rope using the turnbuckle. So how this is how it should be done. So if the height of the structure is less than half of the depth of the saucer, okay, this is nothing to go with this one. So this is how it should be done, that first wires will go down, then on the top of this one, then the saucers will be there. So between them also we can put up some materials also, like dunnages, so that it will not, the wires or something will not exactly turn up the tarpaulin also. So we can put that also, or if not also, it is okay. But this is how, first the wire should go, then the tarpaulin, and then the back should be placed, and then with the help of the wire and turnbuckle we have to tight it. So we have to say this one only, that is wire, then tarpaulin, then backs, and then wire tightening with the turnbuckles. That's it. Okay, so this one is finished, and the tarpaulin strength and all this is written here. It is like not less than 2687. The saucer in the lined with the material accepted to the administration having a tensile strength of not less than 2687 newtons per 5 centimeters, or as an alternative for A15-2, means A15-2 means this one only, a material accepted to the administration having a tensile strength not less than 1344 per 5 centimeters strips. So this is approximately half of that one, may be used if the saucer is constructed as follows. So if it will be constructed like 3.1, 3.2, so if it's constructed like this, then it is accepted. otherwise you have to use the bigger one, 287. So how it is, athwart ship lashing except to the administration shall be placed inside the saucer. So athwart ship lashing, athwart ship means port starboard, lashing acceptable to the administration shall be placed inside the saucer formed in the bulk rein at an interval not more than 2.4. that is this, they are talking about this wire rope only. So they are talking about the wire rope only, that what should be there. This lashing shall be sufficiently long and tightening. Okay, then dunnage is not less than 2.5. this is what I was talking, the dunnages should be placed and all this. So dunnages shall be done when we dunnaging should be placed when we are using this 13441. When we are using 2687, we should not. So it is written that we will use this with dunnage and the line, and we will not use dunnage for this one. So this is simple here, the 2687 we will not use dunnage, 1344 we will use dunnage between the wire rope and the tarpaulin. So this is dunnage size not less than 25 in thickness, suitable material of equal strength and between 150 mm and 300 mm in width shall be placed fore and aft of the lashing to prevent the cutting or chafing of the material. Okay, so this is what, and the saucer shall be filled with a bulk crane and secure at the top except that when using the material and all this. So this nothing, bundling is also like same one only. So in the strapping, it, this is the baggages were placed, and in the bundling we will have like this. So this is wire, then goes in case it is one, the tarpaulin is 1344, then here we will have woods, I mean materials, that is our dunnage. Here we will have in between dunnages so that no chaffing. If we will have a tarpaulin of 1344, and in the tarpaulin we put grain here directly, not in baggages like this, we put directly like this over here, and then we will strap it up. So then we will take the wire, and with the help of turnbuckle we will tighten up, and these wires also should be placed 2.4 meters apart. So if this one is 2.8, this tarpaulin whatever we are using to contain the grain, if it is 2.687 newton per 5 centimeter, then we don't need this here dunnaging. So it will be wire, direct tarpaulin, then grain, and then tighten up the wire with using the turnbuckle. Okay, so next one is A15 has been done. So here this A15 is not written over here, that is for the without DOA what criterias we were studying. So in that it is not written, this means that it can be, here it is written A14, but there is no written A15. So we can do that A15 with DOA also maybe. So actually A14 is like two, saucering and bundling are same things, which is different. So but A14 is written, so that also comes up with this one, and A16 and 17 and 18 are also there. So I will go through A16, 17 and 18. Sixteen is overstowing arrangement. So overstowing, this where bagged grain or the other suitable cargo is utilized for the purpose of securing the partly filled compartment for the free grain surface shall be leveled such as to cover the separation cloth. Okay, cover the separation cloth or equivalent or the suitable platform. Okay, so partly filled compartment, the free grain surface shall be level and shall be covered with separation cloth. So it should be properly leveled up, and then separation clause should be placed that can be suitable anything. Such platform shall consist of bare space not more than 1.2 meter apart and 25 mm boards light thereon spaced not more than 100 mm apart. Platforms may be constructed of other materials provided they are deemed to be okay. So it is like separation cloth shall be placed all over, and such platform shall consist of bearing space not more than 1.2 meter apart. So one platform shall be made. So what is the platform? The board apart and 25 mm boards laying thereon space not more than 100 mm apart. So 25 mm boards we should use it, and it should not be. And here also is something real. The platform or the separation cloth shall be on top of the bagged crane, tightly stored and extending to the height of not less than 1/16 of the maximum breadth of the free grain surface, or 1.2 meters, whichever is greater. Okay, so in this case one, like something is inside and it is not in the form of the bags. So each board shall not be placed not more than 1.2 meters apart, and 25 mm board not spaced more than 100 meter apart. 100 mm 25 meter board laying thereon spaced not more than 100 mm apart. So platforms will be made like 25 into 100, and these platforms shall not be more than 1.2 meters apart. So 25 into 100 platforms are made, and one shall not be more than 1.2 meter apart. And if it is bagged cargo, then once with the bagged grain tightly stored, since then the extent to an height, this should be the height, shall not be less than 1/16 of the maximum breadth of the free grain surface. So it shall, the height shall not be less than 1/16 of the maximum breadth, or 1.2 meters, whichever is greater. So this is also easy. So overstowing shall not be more than 1.2 meters. This also I will show, but after this one, this video, I'll show this one to you.